a lot of teams we've played, we've had a lot of danger men at the top. You had Tammy, you had obviously Peterson for England, and Say Wagington to Oak opening the bat in the last game. So I don't think the West Indies are any different than the party they've got at the top. They've obviously got Chris Gayle there, and they've got Dan Bravo. He's just come into the squad recently, like over the last year, and he's a pretty exciting player. And he's always got Sawan and Chandler pulling the mix as well. So I've got a pretty strong batting line up there, and they've obviously got a good mixture with the ball as well. They've got a bit of pace and Roach, a good variation in their spin as well, in terms of, well, they've obviously got the height of Ben, and then a bit of medium pace then from Sammy and that. So no, they've got good variation in the squad. We necessarily can start comparing our team to other teams. Like, look, we've got our strengths. One of our strengths is our fielding. And the way we go about our work, but West Indies is no different. They've got some of the best athletes and some of the best fielders in their squad in the world. So I think that they've obviously got that power and Chris Gayle up the top, and I don't think you can really compare the two sides. We know our strengths, and that's what we got to stick to, and just go out and play the way we've been playing in the last three games. And if we do that, then I can have no complaints. Yeah, it's definitely an option. It's been an option in other games. Obviously, it was an option against Kevin Peterson as well, or anyone for that matter. Like, a lot of opening batsmen like pace on the ball, and it's definitely an option out here. Like, obviously, Peterson against England for South Africa opened the ball and had success, and I think that any spinner can do that on conditions out here. Obviously, it's a day game tomorrow. We haven't had a day game yet, and in the morning, if you're going to get anything with the new ball, it'll be in the morning as well, so they may swing around a bit, so that may negate the option of opening with the spinner, but it's definitely there, pace off the ball, regardless of who you're playing against. A few laps of the ground there, a few sprints there, so nice. We have to see how he reacts to that tomorrow morning, but he bowled a couple overs in the nets as well, albeit it wasn't a full pelt the last over. He ran in hard, so see how he reacts to that in the morning and make a call in.
How confident are you?
Yeah, well, obviously, I haven't spoke to the physio. I just came straight off training there. I was just judging my own reaction, watching him coming through. He seemed to run through pretty well. I don't think bowling will be a problem. If it is a problem, it's maybe just staying on the park for the 50. I don't know. We'll obviously have to wait and see how he reacts tomorrow, and it'll obviously be 10 overs. We'll be hoping to get out of him if he plays, so he'll have to be 50 bowl of 10 overs to be out there. Yeah, I think that wasn't a great performance on the day a couple of years ago out in the Caribbean. I think that we were still a pretty confident side back then, and we had done a lot of preparation, but we've just grown in experience and in stature since then. It's 2 years ago. It's been a long time in terms of cricketing-wise and in terms of how much we've played, so I think the side's a lot more experienced now. And yeah, obviously, it's been massive for ourselves over the last few years, not only in who we play against, any big team we come up against, he's been massive for ourselves. He picks up on the small things so quickly in terms of looking at opposition players and the like. So no, I think that it'll be no different. He's going to know a lot of their players tomorrow, and it's like ourselves. Like, we knew a lot of England players, and they know a lot about us. So I don't think it's going to be any different come tomorrow with Simo's help.
How